You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to borisfx.com for the premium download.
It's time to begin the rotoscoping task. My footage is loaded into the source window and my session has been created. Silhouette is a node-based system that has inputs and outputs, and my node tree is all connected up. I will cast the shot through and analyze it. I need to roto my subject and landscape, separate from the sky so that the mountains and sky can be enhanced or replaced. Starting with my subject, I don't want to roto her all in one shape because that would be too cumbersome. I want to break up my shapes into different parts to make the work manageable and efficient in relation to keyframing and tracking. For example, let's look at the hat and the glasses. I could try to roto all of this together, but that would not be the best strategy. The head rotates and tilts, goes partially out of frame, and there would be a lot of sections to manage all at once. I also want to make some smart choices for the compositing operations down the line. The fuzzy edge of the hat has a different edge quality from the hard edge of the glasses, and later on it would be advantageous to have these separated out to allow for different edge treatments in the compositing process. I would actually break up the hat and glasses into 5 sections. The same principle carries through for the rest of my shot approach. It's good to separate each part of the object into manageable sections and sections that move differently from each other. Let's start rotoing the hat. I'm going to zoom in here with the plus key, and I'm going to scrub through the shot a little bit and decide what to roto first. I'm going to break up the hat into 5 sections. The area up here, upper screen left, lower screen left, upper screen right, and lower screen right, and the glasses will be separate as well. So I'm going to play through the shot, scrub through, and I'm going to find this section up here where I can see most of the hat where I want to roto it, where it's largest in frame and clearest in frame. It's probably around 90. Okay, so we'll start here. I'm going to zoom in and I'll start making my articulate shape. I'm going to press the B for the B spline and start putting down some points. Sometimes when I start making shapes, I put down too many points and then I can easily just delete them. And I'm going to go out of frame and I'm going to connect the shape or close the shape by pressing the last or the first control point I made. So I'm going to zoom in just a little bit closer and tidy up my shape. I'm going to try to decide if I need to add more points or less. If the quality or the shape of the edge changed a lot, I want to make sure that I scrub through and account for any of those changes, but it looks like it mostly stays the same and the amount of points that I have will be enough. So now's a good time to talk about line placement and point placement. For this class, we're going to be putting the line right at the edge where the last solid pixel is. There is a little bit more detail in this fuzzy hair, but we're going to try to get as much of it in there. There's not a lot of motion blur on this edge, so we don't have to worry about that in this case. And then we'll talk about point placement. So I'm putting the points where I think they're going to do the most work for me and not cause any issues down the line. I don't want to be moving points up and down the line, and I don't want to be putting them too close to each other. I just want them spread out just enough so I have enough options to move the shape if I need to. And now's a good time to look at some of the shape preferences. We'll go to the preferences, silhouette preferences, and we'll go to the shape section. So you can see here, there's a lot of different options. And what I'm going to talk about now is the control handle size. We've done a little bit of that before. We can change it to be bigger. Click apply. We can also change the line width, and to do that we can go to the viewer And you see my line width is 2.8. I can make it 4. Click apply, and you see that it's a lot bigger, but I'm going to change it back to 2.8. So this is a personal preference. Click apply. I'm going to go back to shape and make my point size 5. Click apply, and you can see that updates in the viewer. And then let's just look briefly at the colors section. You can see here that when I created my shape, that it has a red line, and this is the default outline color. I can change it to any other color I want, but I'm just going to leave it at red for now, and we'll go over colors a lot more later. You can see the shape that we've created listed over here in the Roto object list. I can double click on it and name it Demo Shape. And then I can also put this shape in a layer, which is good practice. I can click on the icon down here, the Create Layer icon, and I can drag my shape into the layer. And I can even name the layer. And I'll call this Screen Left Upper Hat. And then you can see here in the object node down here in this window, if I just pull this up a little bit, you can see you have all these different ways to affect the properties of your layer. And if I click on the demo shape itself, you can see all the different options for the shape itself. And I should mention here that silhouette refers to splines as shapes. And then down here below the viewer is the timeline. And you can see here that our keyframe is indicated on frame 90. And if I just scrub through a little bit, you can see on the time bar here that there's a red little tick for the keyframe, which is the color of our shape. And then I should mention that the timeline shares the same space as the nodes. If I click on the nodes tab here, you can see you can select any of the nodes from the different categories. But we'll go back to the timeline and back to our keyframe, and I'll use a hotkey now, Shift X, and that snaps us right back to the next keyframe, which is the only one we have right now, but now it's time to start making some more keyframes.